far as the family's concerned, you're not due back for 2 weeks yet.
Good.
Hey, I thought maybe you'd fly back on the China Clipper.
I don't want nothing between me and the water except a good solid keel.
Come on, let's go.
Same old house, huh?
Yeah, it's the same from the outside, anyhow.
See you tomorrow?
You can see me sooner than that. So long.
Mr. Ricks home?
Yes, sir. Are you expected?
Expected? Why, the pink-toed prophet, it doesn't look that way. What stupid landlubber's idea are all these trick decorations? Sooner, I can see that.
Cappy, you old soul shaker! What a surprise! Oh, I must say, you might have let us know. It throws the entire party out of balance.
Party? But how I...
Not well at all, thank you. Quite ill, in fact. It's been such a task. The house was so undisciplined, I simply had to do the servants all over.
Servants? Where's Maggie Brown?
Maggie Brown?
My cook.
She resigned, didn't she, Brackett? She couldn't take it.
Far be it from me to hurt the wife of my late partner. But, Mrs. Peasely, for 3 years I've withheld any comment about my daughter's marriage to your son. But you remember this. You're his mother and not mine.
Of course! What a sense of humor. Cappy, you've just time to dress. We'll manage to squeeze you into dinner somehow. Frankie and Arlie can help your father. Oh, Revere. Take Mr. Rick's hat. And his coat. And his cigar.
Clear the deck, you lily-livered swarm. Now let's get to the bottom of this.
You can't dig that deep before dinner, darling. There have been so many changes, it'd be better if you took them in very small doses.
I'll take nothing. Who allowed her on the bridge of this ship, anyways?
Allowed? She dropped in for a weekend about a year ago.
A year ago? Or does it just seem that long?
Oh.
Coming to dinner.
The bottom.
Waldo P. Bottomy, the gadget peddler?
Now, wait a minute, Dad. All that has to change. Have you met Waldo Jr.?
No, and if he's anything like Senior, don't want to meet him.
All right. If you want to go through life without speaking to your son-in-law.
Son-in-law? Young Bottomy? What about you and Bill Peck?
Don't mention that stubborn mule to me.
Have you broken off with Bill?
Months ago. He's too bossy. Almost as bad as you.
Oh, you. Waldo P. Bottomy. For 20 years, I've been keeping that old barnacle scraped off of my hull. Now he's got a grip on my stern. Hey, am I seeing things or something?
Not at all. That's an automatic door, and it works with a photoelectric cell right in.
Oh, a Bottomly product, huh? Well, I know one Bottomly product that's not going to get into my family if I have anything to say about it. A fine homecoming.
Now, Cappy, with Frankie and Junior about to be married, I propose that we bury the hatchet.
That might not be so easy.
Nonsense, nonsense. You've saved yourself a lot of trouble. You come around to my way of thinking.
What?
Tell them about the yacht there.
You must have read about it, Cappy. The paper's called Bottomley's Dreamboat.
Going to the yacht business, huh?
Oh, no. Now, don't worry about the competition. It's just a little thing I got the youngsters for a wedding present. For a honeymoon trip.
What kind?
A schooner type, 75-footer. Just too cute for words.
The latest thing, Cappy. All chromium finish.
Wait, you see it, Cappy. It's wonderful. All you do is push a button and things happen.
What about the crew? Well, that's just the point. There isn't any crew. Labor-saving devices by Bottomly Automatic Products Corporation. Progress, Cappy.
Progress. No crew, huh? Just push buttons. Well, what happens if one of them gadgets gets out of whack, huh?
things happen. Mrs. Peasely just told us.
You're not going to see her on any floating switchboard.
I will if I want to, and I want to. I'd like to see anyone try and stop me.
Remember, Cappy, you came home for peace and quiet.
Quiet. I'm telling you, my daughter's not going on that contraption.
You don't know it, but times are passing you by, you old-fashioned granny.
Step outside, you spineless jellyfish, and I'll give you something old-fashioned right on the end of your snoot.
Now, Dad.
What a fine mess you've made of things while I'm gone, turning the house into a nightmare. And do you know when a weekend's over? And you practically ruined the business with your bottomly conveyors, bottomly automatic envelope openers, bottomly everything.
I felt it my duty as general manager.
Manager? Why, you're no longer even able to manage the postage stamps.
Seems your fame is spreading, Matthew, my dear.
And you climb down off of that English accent. I'll get to you in a minute. Where were you when this was going on?
I've resigned.
Nobody resigns from me. I fire them.
You
weren't satisfied with getting your gadgets into my business, but you're trying to get this gadget into my house.
I have all become slovenly and shiftless.
And by the machinery's going out of whack. And then you'll wish you knew how to use your hands and your heads. You addle-brained bunch of button pushers. Come on, Bill, let's get some fresh air.
Cappy Ricks, you sit down there and listen to me.
I'll do nothing of the kind.
Now you listen to me. You're all Mr. Bottomley said. Old-fashioned, behind the times, antiquated.
Now see here, I...
Silence. You've been saying my business this and my business that. It may interest you to know it isn't your business. Not anymore.
What?
Do you want to tell him, or shall I? That is, Mr. Bottomley and myself, bought up old Mr. Ford's interest, and that gives us 51% of the business. In other words, Cappy, we control it.
And now, can I ask what you intend to do with it?
Oh, that's quite simple. We intend to merger with Bottomley Incorporated.
Over my dead body, you will.
Come on, Bill, I gotta go where there's peace and quiet. I gotta figure this mess out.
You're going to try to tell me you can't run my business nor my family anymore, huh?
I don't have to tell you. Mrs. Peasely owns 51% of the business, and she'll go through with that merger just as sure.
Oh, blast Mrs. Peasely.
Well, that's your business. Now, what about your family?
I'll fix them, too, every last one of them.
How? You can't do anything with Matt. He's under his mother's thumb, and you can't keep Ellen from getting a divorce. And you try to tell Frankie what to do, and, well, you just try.
Why, you pin-headed young sport. Ain't nothing the matter with Matt and them girls. It just got soft, that's all. It's their surroundings.
It's Mrs. Peasley.
Right. She ain't altogether to blame either. Bottomley's at the bottom of this. Bill Peck, I'll bet you $5,000 I can clean up this mess, family and business, inside of 3 months. And that goes for Mrs. Peasley, too.
Well, goodbye.
It's a bet.
We'll do it, then.
We? Oh, now, wait a minute. You mean I've got to help you make me lose my bet?
Welching already, huh? Well, I might have known it.
All right. Well, what's your plan?
Listen, young man.
I can't take the business away from Mrs. Peasley. But I can take Mrs. Peasley away from the business before I lose it. Why, in a week's time, I'll have that old hen eaten out of my hand. And that'll be a break for Ellen, too. And as for Frankie, and that pussy willer son of a button.
Lend a hand with the luggage there.
Seems like a dirty trick with the Electra all ready for a maiden voyage.
I know, Waldo. But Cappy's going away on another long trip next Monday. And we simply have to humor him his last weekend, but...
Here, darling, let me help you.
Don't you darling me. I'm only doing this for Cappy. Next Monday, I'm going ahead with my plan.
Ellen, how can you hold such a fault? Bye-bye, Waldo. Dear father, my love, and tell him I'll be back on Monday to sign the merger paper.
Ellen, you're not really going...
Next Monday, I'm flying to Reno. I'm sick and tired of you and your mother.
Oh, stop arguing. Bad enough to spend 2 days on this old washtub.
Washtub? The Gloria Ricks? Why, let me tell you, young lady, she's the finest, dirtiest sailing craft this side of...
Paradise, I know. But wait till you see the Electra.
A toy for a child to play with. Well, let's not waste any more time. Time's just about right. Fine sailing breeze right outside the breakwater.
Deep, Matt. You'll get over it.
I'll never get over it. Not on this cruise, anyway.
I still say you'll get over it.
Oh, it's you.
Now, don't worry. I don't like this any more than you do.
One of Cappy's lesser ideas.
Hey, come on, get off the ropes. Off the ropes!
Very graceful, my dear. But I must say it looked pretty obvious.
Real accidental to me.
I can stand anything for 2 days. Go ahead, enjoy yourselves.
Maybe I shall. He's very attractive. Fellows, hands and all.
Don't look now, Cappy, but look.
the sea, the beautiful sea. I feel so strong and reckless. Isn't this air enervating?
You mean in... Invigorating, Mother.
And the boat is really an exercise. Oh, I'm starving. When do we chow? Or is it mess?
Mess. Take the wheel.
Think you can stand it? You'd like to pull ashore and call the vet off?
No.
I always knew I was not. I could go on sailing forever and ever.
Lady, if you only knew.
Out of me, you big bully.
Ah, now,
Oh, wait a minute, young lady.
Take your hands off me.
I will if you promise not to jump.
Captain Lanning.
Wait a minute, young lady. Sharks down there, you know.
Sharks up here, too. Take this horse car off of me.
Not yet. I'm a good mind to let you wear it for the rest of the trip like a necklace.
But I tell you, Captain, he's not responsible. I'll give you $500 if you put that to port. Don't you see? Cappy's getting old. He's lost his mind.
That's still mutiny. Captain Lennon, if anybody attempts to coerce the crew, you get my orders to throw him an iron.
Aye, sir.
I'll have no more nonsense from you. Get me a job.
Sights and imbeciles. I'll show them.
You've been saying that for a month, and we've been doing the work of six men. It's just a waste of time. I tell you, Cappy, they're hopeless.
Oh, I've been giving them rope.
Yeah, they've been stringing us up with it. Why don't you forget about it and give in?
Cappy.
Yes, sir.
Everything ready?
Yes, sir.
Get going. You get your orders.
Yes, sir.
Give in. Why, I just got started.
Why are we anchored so close to this frightful island? Suppose cannibals came out and murdered us.
The island is uninhabited. That won't stop cannibals.
Mother, when an island is uninhabited, that includes cannibals, too.
That's what I said.
Well, the cruise has been a failure. It's
taken you 8 weeks to find that out.
I thought if we shook off civilization for a while, why, you might toughen up a bit and come to your senses. You see, I was wrong. You can't change human nature.
And it's taken you 60 years to find that out, too.
I'm willing to learn. You can all relax. You win.
I love you anyway, darling. Suppose you are a little slow on the upbeat. No one's perfect. When do we start home?
In the morning.
It's about time you came to what senses you have.
I'm really grateful.
All right, man.
I smell smoke.
Oh!
Oh!
All right, shove off.
Come on, Captain, steward.
Never mind about them.
Why aren't they coming?
We'll be all right. If we can't put out the fire, we'll get off the tack.
Starving to death.
You mean we may be stuck here indefinitely?
One big happy family.
Cappy, how deliciously thoughtful. Everything's a stop housekeeping.
Reminds me of when I was first married.
What a memory.
All this heavenly...
Braddock speaking. Daily report to CR. Steady breeze, 11 knots, 145 degrees, 13 minutes, 18 seconds north, 300 miles south by southeast of Hawaii.
They'll be in port in less than a month.
You better tell the family. It's going to be much worse when they find out for themselves.
They never will.
How are you going to explain the Gloria Ricks?
She's going to be dismantled. In about a month, one of my ships will pick us up. Landing will be aboard with the alibi. Gloria Ricks lost at sea. He and the steward picked up by a passing ship. That's simple enough.
Yeah, but it doesn't help me. After the heroic way we abandoned the Gloria Ricks, how well do you suppose I stand in with Frankie?
Well, what do you care? You're not in love with her.
Who says I'm not?
You said so a dozen times.
Said she was useless. Be careful of this tropic atmosphere, my lad. It's balmy down here.
Well, things won't be so balmy when I tell her the truth about the Gloria Ricks.
Now, don't forget your promise, Bill.
Oh, you got me all tied down with promises.
Share of the work, but those two lazy monsters might help.
Help? They expect you to be grateful to them.
For what? Allowing us to breathe? We clean, cook, wash their clothes, and they live in luxury, while we sleep like monkeys in the tree.
Well, there's no law against building yourself a house, and no time either. Poor Matt wants to. Don't work or starve. Well, that's their motto.
That's Bill's motto. He's so masterful. Matt, say something.
Hello.
Poor Matthew. Are you exhausted?
Yes, and I'm full of blisters, too. I have all the dirty work to do while Bill and Cappy go fishing. Why don't they build us a house? I'll do the fishing.
You get seasick if you look at the water.
Who elected Bill head of this outfit, anyway?
Ellen, you're so obvious, my dear. You should talk.
Bill Peck means nothing to me, no matter how many fish he catches. Why, he was the last available man on earth.
He is, for you.
Poor Frankie, torn between the devil and a desert island.
Now, my dear, don't let this temporary tragedy lead you into doing anything hasty. Just hold a strong foot on Waldo, and it'll come true. Don't weaken, my dear, just because Bill is so good-looking and masterful.
I see. That's the reason you're warning me against it. Well, I don't trust him.
Up there. Can I help?
No, thanks. Where's Ellen? Oh, she usually helps me.
Hello, Frankie.
Can I help?
I can manage.
Shall I hold the gourd?
No, thanks. Ellen usually does that.
Oh. Where did you learn that? British West Indies? Bill! Can I catch him for you?
No, thanks. I've got a catcher.
Hi there, Frankie.
Remember, you're a long way from Reno.
Fish.
Balsam down to Ellen.
Yes, we had so much fun.
I imagine.
What's the matter with the eggs?
I prefer the fish. The eggs taste too fishy.
What do you expect seabirds' eggs to taste like? Milk and honey?
I was merely voicing my preference. Is there any objections?
Well, I think I'll hike up to the cliff and light the signal fire. Matt, did you chop plenty of wood?
Yes, I worked this afternoon.
Say, I can stand a walk. I'll go along with you.
No,
oh,
thanks.
I'll go with him. It's your time to do the dishes. You can't get out of that.
Well, I think I'll strike the hay. That's the work.
I've got a surprise for you.
You couldn't surprise me.
Oh, I don't know about that. Wait till you see.
I'm not interested. Here.
Holly, you know I'm mad about you. I'd do anything for you. Anything.
You would?
Anything, darling.
Then go punch your mother right on the nose.
Ellen, how could you?
What's bothering you, Frankie?
Nothing.
Mighty unhappy to me.
I'm not unhappy. Can't a girl have a little peace and quiet to think about things?
Oh, sure. I didn't mean to butt in.
Oh, I'm sorry, Cappy. But do you think there's any chance of us ever getting away from this place?
We can hope.
Now, Cappy, you can't hope yourself off of an island. Suppose we're stuck here for the rest of our lives. What then?
I don't know.
Well, I mean, of course we've dropped most of the conventions of civilization, but...
You're missing?
Well, no, it isn't that, but... Well, there's some things that you just can't drop.
Like what?
Well, how in the dickens can a girl get married in a place like this?
That's so funny.
Frankie, she wants to get married.
Married? Oh, yes. Fine thing. She and Bill.
No, no.
Congratulations.
No, no. You can't rush into a thing like that.
What is there to wait for?
Oh, you've got to give it some thought. You got to think about it.
I've been doing nothing but thinking lately.
Well, it's high time both she and Bill settled down.
What did Bill say about it?
Bill? Well, I haven't mentioned it to him.
Help. What are you doing up here?
Well, you see, I've been thinking.
Patient on road to recovery.
Bill, may I talk seriously to you for a minute?
I don't know. Can you?
Oh, come on, sit down.
Will be. But even if we weren't, there's worse places in the world than this.
Don't you ever think about getting home?
Why think about it?
All right. Let's think about us, right here. Are you satisfied to do nothing but fish and steal eggs for the rest of your life?
What else is there to do?
Bill, we were engaged to be married once. Remember?
Sure, and you?
I know. It was all my fault. Remember the way you used to put your arms around me?
That's the first thing I remember to forget.
There. Like that. You know, you're coming up here every night and starting that fire is a joke.
Well, what makes you think that?
Oh, we're way off the ship lane. We'll never be seen.
Well, suppose,
All right. Let's wait the rest of our lives and suppose. Aren't you ashamed of yourself? Making me propose?
Frankie?
Now, you let me tell you something, young lady. It was your fault we called it off in San Francisco. If
we ever get back there again, it's liable to be the same thing. Well, rather than that, let's forget about it.
Because you love me?
Yes. And there's another reason why we've got to wait.
Nothing can be that important.
Well, it is, though. Besides, we couldn't get married even if we wanted to.
But we
want
to. We can.
Smells good. Say, what are you celebrating?
Well, yep. I don't know whether it's your cooking or my appetite, but every day I seem to be eating more and more.
You don't seem to show it, Mrs. Peasely.
Thank you, William.
I was kind of late last night, wasn't it?
Uh-huh. Where's Frankie? Down the beach, taking a swim.
What's the occasion? Somebody having a birthday? Good morning. Let's eat.
Hey, that's all anybody seems to think about these days.
I don't know about that.
Now, what are you going to spring?
Well, last night Bill and I decided to become man and wife.
What? You mean you... Why, scandalous. No, that's putting it mildly. It's impossible.
Why is it?
Why? Why, indeed? Do you mean to sit here and flaunt the conventions under our very noses?
What convention?
Why, it's immoral. That's all I've got to say.
What's immoral about getting married?
Married? Huh? But what about Waldo?
Well, what about it? Now, there's no use arguing. We've decided.
You mean you have? Well, I haven't. If you two callous brutes won't protect this helpless girl, I will with my last breath.
Save your breath, Mrs. Peasely. We are going to be married.
But there isn't a minister, not even a justice of the peace.
Bill, you tell him.
Cappy's a licensed sea captain.
But he isn't at sea.
Well, he's the only one who isn't.
This is fire enough to ship you off, my lad. Stand up. We talk in the boat. This marriage might sound informal, but that ain't going to prevent it from sticking. It's going to be awful legal.
It can't be any too legal for me.
And that can wait till after ceremony. The wave knocked me off my balance.
Cappy's losing his sea legs. Cappy's losing his sea legs.
Cut that out now. We get down to business.
Bad day for Cappy. He's also losing his daughter.
Are you sure you could do this without the book?
Why, I've tried dozens of them at sea in my time. I know the words by heart.
Oh, God. Stop shaking. You'll upset the boat.
It's warming up.
Yeah, it is getting warm.
Oh, Cappy, get going. Between the sun and the excitement, I'm afraid he'll faint.
Aye, mate. We are gathered here in this dory today to join this happy couple in the holy bonds of matrimony.
What's the matter with you?
I know you've never tried anything like this before, but after all, Bill...
That's right. Maybe we'd better talk.
We can do that after marriage. Do you, William Peck, take this woman to be your lawful wedded wife, to love, honor, and provide for so long as you shall live? Well, do you? Come on.
Any minute now.
What's the matter with you, Bill? Do you or don't you?
No, yes, I do, but I...
Well, it's all right so far, then. Do you, Frankie...
Francis.
Oh, yeah, Francis. Do you, Francis Ricks, take this man to be your lawful wedded husband, to love, honor, and cherish, so long as you shall live?
I
do.
That's what they all say. And now, Abner and Ben
will
conclude the program.
I guess you didn't know about this. We forgot to tell you.
That isn't all you forgot to tell me. All right, come on, out with the truth.
Why, Francis, it was all in fun.
Don't you, Francis, me. So, that's the reason you came fishing at the same hour every day. You were in touch with someone.
Sort of.
Captain Lanning and the steward weren't lost.
No.
And it wasn't a real fire.
No. Smoke pots and oily rags where it wouldn't do any damage.
So that's the reason you were so brave about it all. That's the reason you didn't mind being here while we were frightened to death. You were laughing at us. My hero. Robinson Crusoe, Jr. You were going through with the wedding. You tricked me.
I didn't want to marry you in the first place. I told you so.
You said you loved me.
Well, I do love you, but I...
You snake in the wood pile. When are we going to be picked up?
In about 2 weeks.
Wait until Mrs. Peasely hears about this.
This is Stacy. Finale Twice, San Francisco. We now bring you a half hour of dance music by Harry Brown and his singing swingsters. Give out, Harry.
Mind you get them clean. You two have got a lot of dishwashing to make up, though.
Yeah, and a lot of wood chopping to do, too.
You need something of a man out of him, the fool.
Less talk, the more work you'll get done.
Just wait.
You wait till you get back to San Francisco. You two will be arrested at the dock. Not only do they kidnap us, they'll get life at least for that. For trapping this poor girl into marriage.
I wasn't married and I wasn't trapped.
You'll rue the day you had this idea, Mr. Cappy Ricks.
You pipe down now, you old salamander. Let me tell you something. When we came here 2 months ago, why, you were as silly and spineless a crew as ever called themselves human. Why, you couldn't even lace your shoes, let alone do a day's work. Well, now you can. You'll get back safe enough, and you'll be all the better off for the experience.
All but you. What I go through is a wonder I'm alive.
Why, you're more alive now than you ever were, you old battle axe.
How dare you talk to me like that? The way you've treated me. The shame. Generation.
You mean degradation, Mother. Only you don't mean it. Cap is right. It's done us all a lot of good. And I, for one, am grateful.
Well, Matthew.
Now, just a minute. Let me finish. I mean every word I've said. And if you weren't so darn selfish and...
Oh, my heart. Oh, I'm going to faint.
Now, go ahead and faint.
Thanks, man. Oh, it was nothing at all.
But every time I think of the way you made me chop that wood and carry it up that cliff.
Oh, that was all in fun.
Fun? I like that. I die laughing every time I think how close I came to marrying that baboon.
Well, don't blame Bill. That was your idea, Frankie.
Yes, but why? I thought, well, what else was there to do? We were really going to be stuck on this island.
Oh, sure. Just using me as a last chance. Well, don't worry. You'll soon be back with Waldo. And you can renew your acquaintanceship with all the inmates of the nightclubs and traffic courts.
We interrupt the program for a newsflash. The doom of the Gloria Ricks, stout little yacht of the noted Alden P. Cappy Ricks, was read today in floating wreckage picked up from the storm-lashed waters of the Pacific. Last heard from when 900 miles west of San Francisco, the yacht with its 8 humans aboard is believed to have gone down with all hands. The shipowner's guests on the tragic cruise were his 2 daughters, Ellen and Frances, Matthew Peasely, and the latter's mother, Mrs. Amanda Peasely. All Pacific Shipping continued on the lookout in the slim hope that some of the passengers and crew are still afloat in a lifeboat.
And me too. And I've stood about all I'm going through.
Stop it. You're hurting me.
Come on. I've got something I want to show you.
Suppose I refuse.
Not a chance, my dear. And so I figured if we're going to have to be here together for the rest of our lives, we might as well make the best of it. We used to love each other, didn't we?
Yes. That was before your mother...
Now, let's not go into that again. Look. I built this all by myself. Resourceful, self-reliant, ingenuity. That's me.
Step in. It's not bad at all.
Of course it's not. Step in and look around, will you?
Now, this is why I took so long to chop firewood.
I know it's nothing pretentious, but it's home. And this is where we're going to live from now on.
Oh, Matt.
And another thing. We're going to have a family.
What? Oh, no. I'm not going to be tied down.
Oh, just a minute. That's what you said in San Francisco. But it doesn't apply here. You no longer have any choice.
You're crazy.
Oh. All this work. Now I'll have to rebuild it.
Never mind, darling. You'll have me to help you.
Well, Cappy, looks like you've won your bet all right. But I'll probably have to pay you off in coconuts.
How's that?
You set out to make your family self-reliant, didn't you? You've done more than that. Matt and Ellen are a pair of lovebirds, and Frankie and Mrs. Peasely are getting along like a couple of campfire girls.
See, Bill, why don't you try reasoning with Frankie?
She doesn't even know the meaning of the word.
I guess you're right. I'm just a meddling old man.
Well, people. Now, we're all in this thing, and the least you can do is try to make the best of it.
He doesn't like our country. Why doesn't he go back where he came from?
I can try.
Now, wait a minute.
I knew somebody would go crazy before long.
I don't know why I didn't think of it before. I'll get you people back to San Francisco if it's the last thing I ever do.
What time does the next ferry boat leave?
Never mind the wisecracks, Mrs. Waldo, Jr. Now, get this. We're about 300 miles off the ship lanes. Give me the dory with 2 weeks' provisions. I'll rig a sail out of that canvas, and I'll get help or else.
Oh, Bill, that's suicide. The storm's about to start, and you wouldn't last 5 minutes if you got in one.
I'll take a chance. I'll go with you.
No, Matt, you mustn't. I'll go.
I don't need any help. At what?
We've been here this long. We can wait a couple of months longer till the danger of typhoons is over, then I'll take a chance.
No, you won't.
Since when have you been giving me on? If Bill told you he had anything to do with getting into this mess, he's lying. Because whatever he did was done under my orders. He was against it from the start, and if anybody gets out of here, it's going to be me.
Look! Look!
Myself. You're a button.
You'll be in jail 24 hours after we dock.
Why, you...
Now, Bill, cut it out. You've got to let off steam. Push yourself a button.
That's an idea.
Heavy weather.
I'll let it come. The electric can take it.
Getting a bit rough, isn't it?
You
shouldn't have left your stateroom, Mrs. Peasely.
I wanted to tell you we'll be ready for the ceremony in 15 minutes.
I don't believe I can leave.
But you must. You've got to perform the ceremony. Isn't it really rough engagement, smooth marriage?
Where's Cappy?
He's pouting.
Kind of rough out, eh, Cappy?
What's the matter? You upset about that merger?
No. I just can't get over my own daughter doing this to me.
There's no tooling for you. She's doing it to Waldo Jr.
I never forgive her for it.
Now, wait a minute, Cappy.
I won't wait a second. Stubborn little fool. Why, she don't want that lily-livered slob. It's because he rescued her, she feels obligated. I'm going to put a stop to this, and I'm going to put a stop to that merger, too.
Now, you remember what you said on the island?
What?
That you were a meddling old fool who couldn't mind his own business?
Did I say that?
Sure did. Must have been talking in my sleep.
Bill, it's going to be 3 days before this storm blows over.
What's that got to do with it?
Well, you ever notice anything funny about this bloated showcase?
Yeah, it's got a lot of buttons.
Right. Radio control, automatic steering, automatic compass, automatic everything. Just went down the engine room. The whole shebang runs from one switch.
Well, I don't know anything about all these gadgets.
Well, neither do I, but I do know that old Bottomley can't stand it without it.
What about the crew?
Two men. The steam sailor and the steward.
I've seen marriages under very strange circumstances, but never like this. Stop lurching, will you?
I'm standing still. It's the boat.
Oh, I think you're crazy to go through with this. You don't want to?
Of course I do. Besides, where would I be if it weren't for Waldo?
Safe on the island. In Bill Peck's arms.
He's not interested. Besides, I haven't seen him burning any bridges to stop me.
Where are the bridges?
Well, if he were resourceful, he'd do something about it.
What do you want him to do? Stop the ship?
Sure. Hero fights the storm.
what we'll do. If old Bush Button will come down here personally and agree to turn to his sailor.
Oh, he won't. He swore he wouldn't. Oh, don't you be stubborn. You know he has a bill of iron.
Well, it's suddenly become awfully rusty.
Well, here's it, Captain. He's having fine sailing with me, Captain.
I order both of you up on deck immediately.
What for?
Sail this ship.
Hear the captain's orders?
I command you.
Now you listen to me, you mealy mouth, button pushing parasite. You may be the captain of this ship, but you'll never give Cappy Ricks orders. They can sink as far as I'm concerned, and there's only one way you'll ever see land again.
Well, I didn't mean to.
And I'll sail it in under one condition, and I want that made in the presence of everybody on board.
Well, anything within reason.
Well, come on. We'll sail up.
That's what Cappy said. It worked.
What am I supposed to do?
I suppose you want conditions, too.
Certainly.
Why?
Peasely, not only is the merger out, but here it is, clause number 5. You're going to sell me back every bit of stock you own in my company. Is that clear?
Yes, Cappy.
That's blackmail.
Shut up. Sign on the dotted line. And another thing, before I forget it, you're going to take all those gadgets out of my house and leave it the way it was. And then, Mrs. Peasely, you're going to strand.
Yes, Cappy. But where do I strand?
Iceland, Peru, Borneo, I don't care. And as for you, Bottomley, you're going to take all those automatic cargo loading gadgets to the old man and give him the money back.
But, Captain, Mr. Ricks to you, buddy.
How about it?
Okay, but I think you're making a terrible mistake.
The only mistake I'm making is not popping you one right in the end of your snoop.
Six bells and all is well.
You're down to